History Film Festival i dalje ponosno nosi titulu jedinog međunarodnog festivala koji se bavi isključivo povijesnim dokumentarnim filmovima. Od 10. do 14. rujna ove godine History Film Festival se po treći put zaredom vraća pred svoju postojeću, ali i neke nove publike. Filmovi koje ćemo prikazivati u ovogodišnjem programu ponovno na neke nove, pomaknute, originalne načine pričaju nepoznate detalje iz poznate povijesti, otkrivaju tajne živote svjetski poznatih ličnosti ili pak otkrivaju priče o junakinjama i junacima čije su priče u povijesti prešućene. Ove godine History Film Festival širi se i na neke druge lokacije. Kao i do sadašnjih godina, glavnina programa održavat će se u HKD-u na Sušaku, ali će riječka publika moći filmove gledati i u zajednici Taljana, odnosno u Čirkolu. Publika će filmove moći gledati također i u Matuljima, Novom Vinodolskom i Crikvenici.
Na ovogodišnji History Film Festival prijavilo se 140 filmova iz 38 zemalja svijeta, a u selekciji je odabrano 30 filmova koje će naša publika imati prigodu vidjeti. Ono što obilježava ovogodišnju selekciju i ovogodišnji program History Film Festivala jesu žene. Naime, žene kao autorice i žene kao teme filmova na History Film Festivalu definitivno dominiraju i imat ćemo prigodu upoznati čitav niz vrlo snažnih, pametnih, mudrih i žena koje su mijenjale povijest. Versailles.
At the very limits of the domain of Versailles stands an odd little village from another time. The Queen's Hamlet is the secret refuge of Marie Antoinette, where she escaped her ceremonial life at the court of Versailles. It's here she sought happiness, the one thing forbidden to a queen.
It's the story of how Marie Antoinette transformed Versailles and how Versailles transformed Marie Antoinette. Each of her architectural creations, the Petit Trianon, the English Garden, the Hamlet, took her further and further from the palace and her ceremonial duties at the court. But in trying to escape the rigors of the court, she unwittingly destroyed the system that Louis XIV had put in place to control the aristocracy. The nobility turned on her long before the French people, and in doing so, sealed their fate as well as hers. The fictional sequences aren't conceived as reenactments. They tell a parallel story, destiny. Marie Antoinette's life seems to have been written in advance. She didn't choose to be a queen, she was a political pawn. And ultimately, it wasn't the pursuit of pleasure or extravagance that brought her down. She was seeking something much more simple, personal happiness. But that's not in the job description of a queen. I hope you enjoy the film, and many thanks to the History Film Festival for inviting the secret Versailles of Marie Antoinette.
Rosemary is the eldest daughter of the Kennedy children and the sister of JFK.
Bauhaus 100 poseban je program History Film Festivala koji je posvećen 100. godišnjici Bauhausa. Bogati raznolik program objedinjuje putujuću svjetsku izložbu pod nazivom Bauhaus Imaginista, bogat filmski program koji nudi nove filmske naslove nastale posebno za 100. godišnjicu Bauhausa, ali i stare filmove iz 20. i 30. godina koje su radili sami Bauhausovci.
Weimar. It was here that Berlin architect Walter Gropius founded the Bauhaus in 1919.
Walter Gropius hat eine ganze Reihe von Künstlern als Bauhausmeister berufen, unter anderem Wassily Kandinsky, Lionel Feininger, Paul Klee.
When you think of Bauhaus, you think of modern architecture, beautiful design and colorful figures.
Bauhaus und das Goethe-Institut haben viel miteinander zu tun. Das Bauhaus ist eine wichtige architektonische und designerische Bewegung zwischen den beiden Weltkriegen, zwischen 1919 und 1933. Und das Bauhaus hat nicht nur in Dessau und in Weimar sehr große Bedeutung gehabt, sondern das Bauhaus ist als Bewegung für neues Bauen, für neues Design, für neue Architektur rund um die Welt gegangen. Deswegen kümmert sich das Goethe-Institut auch sehr darum, dass wir die weltweiten Einflüsse, die das Bauhaus gehabt hat und die auf das Bauhaus zurückgewirkt haben, dass wir das darstellen können. Die Goethe-Institute in der Welt haben sich vorgenommen, auch in ihren Ländern zu schauen, was das Bauhaus für Auswirkungen gehabt hat. In Kroatien sind wir sehr glücklich, dass wir ein Schwerpunktthema entwickeln konnten, das heißt Frauen im Bauhaus. Es geht ein bisschen zurück auf eine wichtige Sammlung im Museum für zeitgenössische Kunst in Zagreb, die sogenannte Bettelheim-Sammlung, aber auch zurück auf einige der Protagonistinnen aus Kroatien, die im Bauhaus für ein Jahr oder auch länger studiert haben und dort gelernt und einflussreiche Arbeiten hinterlassen haben. Eine davon ist Otti Berger. Wir freuen uns besonders, dass wir im Rahmen des historischen Filmfestivals nun eine Ausstellung zeigen können, Bauhaus Imaginista in der Kotthill-Galerie. Diese Ausstellung ist so wichtig, weil sie genau diese weltweiten Einflüsse deutlich macht. Die Ausstellung kümmert sich nicht so sehr um Bauhaus in Deutschland.
If you want vision, you need visionaries.
Filmski program započinje filmom Uspon i pad smeđeg bizona redatelja Filipa Rodrigueza i producenta slavnog Oskarovca Benicia del Tora.
Once in every century, there comes a man who was chosen to speak for his people.
I've never met anybody like him.
Oscar was a wild boy.
A Baptist missionary, clarinet player, peach picker, lawyer, leader of the Chicano movement.
A brown buffalo.
It is the police department and the sheriff's department that produce a lot of this crime that we hear of.
They felt Oscar was a threat to their leadership.
Oscar had a taste for excess.
Hello, everybody. My name is Philip. I'm the director of a film you're going to see called The Rise and Fall of the Brown Buffalo. I'm greeting you from California, where it's very warm today. That's why I have sweat on my face. So pardon that. This film is about a man who didn't get his due historically. And it's apt that you're witnessing him at a history festival. U.S. cinema has privileged the point of view of the white male subject to a great, horrific degree. Only now are non-whites, other peoples that represents this complex tapestry of this vast population in the U.S., starting to insist upon their own way of telling the story of themselves.
Our representatives are not in the government. They're going to keep on killing us. I swear to God they're going to keep on killing us. They're going to wipe us out.
The tale of Oscar's fall from grace is rife with bad blood and ugly paranoia.
It's always the brown man or the black man or the poor man that does the dirty work. We are the janitors of the world.
Pozivamo vas da nam se idućih dana pridružite u Rijeci na History Film Festivalu.